Thank you so much, Ben. Next, we welcome Justin Borgman, who is the CEO of Starburst, and prior to Starburst, an executive at Teradata, helping them on their big data journey with their Hadoop-based products. The title of this talk is Data Mesh is a Big Idea, Taking Your Team from Vision to Reality. And Justin makes the bold claim that data mesh is the need for data mesh is 3 decades in the making. We've learned a lot as an industry on how to best store data, how to best manage data, but we still have a ways to go at scale analyzing data. And we need a better way to help companies become analytics-driven. Data mesh holds a promise of that better way, but it's a big idea. As such, it needs to be broken down in terms of execution steps over time. And Justin will walk us through his perspective on how to move from that vision to reality in steps over time and bring your ecosystem of partners along on that journey.
Thanks, Brandon. I'm Justin Borgman, co-founder and CEO of Starburst. I'm excited to be here exploring the state of data mesh. At Starburst, we've been following Jamak's work since her first article was published. We immediately felt aligned with the concept she outlined for helping companies get more out of distributed data and bring more ownership to the teams that know their data best. We also very much aligned with her reasoning as to why we all needed a better way to manage and analyze data at scale. In my talk today, I'll share my point of view on where data mesh is today, how I think companies should step forward, and what Starburst is doing to help. First, I want to talk you through what I plan to share today. We're going to start by traveling back in time to understand why data mesh is so hot. Next, we'll explore just how big of an idea data mesh is and talk through the challenges and benefits of big ideas. Lastly, we'll close on breaking data mesh down into achievable milestones for your organization. I'll share our perspective on how to get started and how Starburst can help. If you take nothing else away today, know that you're not alone in your journey towards data mesh. So let's get started. First, we need to hop in a time machine and travel 40 years into the past. Let's start with the earliest days of digitization and the creation of databases to store that data efficiently. As databases proliferated across the enterprise, companies began to consolidate their data from these different database systems so they could understand their business more completely. This was the birth of the data warehouse, and along with it came the necessity to extract, transform, and load data from multiple source systems into this one central repository. Over time, many companies even adopted multiple data warehouses. In 1978, Teradata was the first purpose-built data warehousing appliance designed to consolidate all of your data into one system, ultimately hoping to create a single source of truth. Now let's fast forward to the 2000s and the era of truly big data. Internet companies led the way, expanding our vocabulary from gigabyte to terabyte, petabyte, and exabyte as these new companies were 100% digital, capturing data about every interaction on their web properties. As a result, Hadoop was born, bringing a much more cost-effective and scalable storage solution compared to traditional data warehousing. The data lake was born. It was cheaper, but it was hard to access data for analytics. My first company, Hadapt, pioneered the SQL and Hadoop approach to addressing this problem. But we were acquired by Teradata in 2014, and the speed and quality of data analytics on Hadoop continued to pose challenges. The rise of the cloud and the creation of even more database systems has created tremendous data sprawl across one cloud, multiple clouds, and some systems still on-prem. Add to that the ever-changing global regulatory environment, which now requires that some data remain in specific geographies where it was created. Data is truly everywhere, and that is not going to change. Yet most of the trends of the last few years have been nothing more than incrementalism, reusing 40-year-old technologies and repurposing them for the cloud era. The cloud data warehouse remains just as monolithic as its bare metal cousins on-prem, and it repeats the futility of centralization. We believe that centralization is much slower than it looks because it's not just about query performance. It's about the total time to insight. I would love to see a TPCH or TPCDS benchmark that measures the weeks and months of human time, orders of magnitude more expensive than CPU time, that it took to get the data in the data warehouse before the first query could be run. The data warehouse model requires many copies of the same data in source systems, intermediate copies, and copies in that data warehouse. It creates tremendous vendor lock-in and exponential costs while trying to achieve that single source of truth, which is actually a single point of failure. And it limits your view to what is in that enterprise data warehouse right now at that particular moment in time. How accurate is that? One of the reasons the monolithic data warehouse model will never work is what I like to call the Stonebreaker principle. Mike Stonebreaker, renowned professor at MIT and creator of Ingress, Postgres, Vertica, and a number of other database systems, famously said there is no one-size-fits-all database system, and that for every type of job, you're going to have a database that is purpose-built for that task. You're going to use Mongo, you're going to use Kafka, you're going to have Elastic, Oracle, and the list goes on. You're also going to have departmental data marts, you're going to have transactional and operational data stores. You're going to inherit even more data assets through mergers and acquisitions, and you're going to create new applications and new devices. All of this is going to create more and more data silos. Today, companies are on a collision course between their business needs and the capabilities of the technology present. Every organization wants their teams to be data-driven. They want their businesses to use data as a competitive advantage. But because data is everywhere, and the leading analytics systems limit how much data you can move and how quickly you can analyze it, we're stuck. Teams waste time waiting. Data engineers spend all of their time building and managing pipelines. I think we can all agree that we need a better way, a way that really empowers our teams to access all of the data they need when they need it. We need a faster way because time is of the essence. Your business can't afford to wait. We all need a more open way, one that works with where you're at and where you're going, the tools you have today and those that you'll adopt tomorrow, one that doesn't force hard trade-offs of cost versus capability. Data mesh is a big idea for a better way forward. It offers a model that works with your data reality, the reality that your data is forever distributed, whether you like it or not. Data mesh not only acknowledges that reality as a practical truth, it embraces it, and it offers benefits to decentralization. It distributes data management responsibility to domain owners who know their data best. It treats data as a first-class product to be shared and consumed across the organization. It understands the importance of good governance and recognizes the value of self-service infrastructure necessary to lead us towards data democratization. If you've read any of the articles surrounding data mesh, you'll hear a consistent tone. Great idea in theory, but I think this is the age-old problem with big ideas. Big ideas challenge the status quo. They challenge our belief system. They involve changing not just your mind, but many minds. And there are behavior changes that need to occur as well. And data mesh is no exception to this. It involves people, process, and technology change. But big ideas are what move us forward as a civilization. Big ideas change the world. For instance, electricity. It's fair to say that we're all benefiting from electricity since you're joining this conference virtually. But for centuries, electricity was nothing more than an intellectual curiosity. In fact, Edison's first light bulb was dismissed as unworthy of the attention of practical men. Similarly, we have airplanes. They were once referred to as having no military value. There are countless examples in computing, beginning with the earliest days of the personal computer. The CEO of Digital Equipment Corporation famously said, "There is no reason anyone would want a computer in their home." This one's fun. Coming further into the future in the early 2000s, I remember being told in college that I wasn't allowed to use Wikipedia, that it wasn't accurate, and it would never replace encyclopedias. In database history, there was similar skepticism over the rise of relational database models replacing the hierarchical model that was dominant at the time. Despite initial resistance, people ultimately realized that relational databases today are simply a better fit for our data reality. So here we are. We come back to data mesh, and we can see why people are circumspect regarding such a paradigm shift. However, it is a big idea that is worth pursuing, and I want you to know that you are not alone on this journey. We are here to help. And it is indeed a journey, and you get to decide which destinations are right for you along the way. Let me explain what I mean. First, we believe most companies are still attempting to operate in the centralization paradigm, whether your center of gravity is a data warehouse or a data lake. We particularly love data lakes because it is the least expensive place to store your data and allows you to use open data formats to avoid vendor lock-in. In fact, Starburst began as the world's fastest query engine for a data lake, querying hundreds of petabytes of data and serving thousands of concurrent queries for some of the largest internet companies in the world. Some people call that a lake house architecture, and we do lake house better than anyone. However, as great as data lakes are, you undoubtedly have data elsewhere too. We believe the best first step is to develop connectivity across all of your traditional database systems that store core data. That way, you can query core data and new data without needing to move it. For example, you might run a SQL join across billing data in a traditional data warehouse with clickstream data in your data lake. Starburst offers nearly 50 connectors to a wide variety of data sources and offers advanced features around caching and the creation of materialized views across data sources. Your data consumers can use their analytics tools of choice, whether that's ThoughtSpot, Tableau, Power BI, Looker, Click, or what have you. Once you have connectivity across those data sources, you've laid the foundation. Now you're ready to truly begin your data mesh journey. From here, you may start by empowering your different business domains to create and share secure data products across the organization. Today, I'm excited to share some highlights of our new data product features in Starburst Enterprise. You can now use Starburst to create, publish, manage, and find data products that are built on multiple datasets. A key aspect of what we've developed is that we allow data engineers to define relevant metadata to data consumers. Ultimately, these data products are only useful if they're analyzed and deliver value, so you can use Starburst as the query engine for your data products. Another element we think is critical to successful data product adoption is the ability to share those data products. We're starting with the ability to share internally today. You may have seen Join the Lab on these screenshots, and I'm referring to the Data Product Lab run by our Director of Engineering, Dr. Colleen Tartow, and Head of Data Products, Vishal Singh, later tomorrow. There, you'll learn a lot more about what we can help you with today and what other features are coming in the near future. Over time, you'll be ready for more complex business and process change, building a truly self-service platform that includes federated governance. To that end, we've also recently released a greater level of access control to support securing your data products. We also have partners such as Immuta and Privacera who can work with you on advanced data governance. Ultimately, a successful data mesh strategy puts the power of data into the hands of every member of your organization and allows your business to move quickly throughout change. I want to thank the ThoughtWorks team for inviting me to speak today. I look forward to seeing what this year has to bring for data mesh success stories.